Market Gardener, why are you so epic? God, I love this weapon. I haven't used it in so long, so it's refreshing to use it once again. I tried to mix up my soldier loadout a little bit because I've been doing those same boring old soldier things nonstop. So right here, got the rocket launcher, the gunboats, which I don't use too often, and going back to the Market Gardener, which of course will crit people if you hit someone while you're in the air after a rocket jump. Not the easiest thing to do, but you do get a sweet 195 damage for doing it. And in just a moment, I am going to be bringing the pain to that heavy over there with my Market Gardener right about... Let's go. And he blew up. That happens way more than you would think, where you try and jump on someone and they die right before that kill, and it takes your moment from you. That was my moment, and I did not get it. But in just a second, right after I capture this point, I see that there is a medic over there, and he's definitely got my eye, so jump over here. He's got Uber. Land on him, but completely miss the Market Gardener. He still pops anyway, so I guess my job was done. Glory gone again. Could have gotten a sweet kill on a medic there, but did not pull it off. It is usually a lot better to land next to the person you're trying to Market Garden, so you have more time to land, and you don't have to aim below your feet. So that was a mistake on my part. You should be landing right next to the person. It makes it a lot easier than landing on their head. Of course, not using the man treads, so I don't really benefit from that at all. It just makes the swing a bit harder to do. And this map, by the way, a custom map, currently in beta. There are a few textures missing because it's still a work in progress, but for the time being, it is still probably my favorite King of the Hill map that I've played. It's just laid out really well. I like the high ground advantage that the point has, but it's not overpowering in a way that the attackers coming at it aren't at a severe disadvantage because the map is rather wide. If they attack from the left or the right, you usually can't cover both of them. And so it is a lot of fun, and there's a heavy over there on the other side. I'm going to be trying to Market Garden him in a second, but as I said, people often die before you get to them. Not that my rocket jump was spot on anyway, but kind of expected anyway. It wasn't entirely expecting to get that one. I am playing not with a focus on the Market Gardener, but just keeping in mind whenever I see an opportunity like this big old fat guy, bonk, just go for it. Don't stress it. Don't be like, oh, I'm going to Market Garden everybody all around. I just kind of have it in my pocket so that when I need it and when I see an opportunity, why not go for it? It actually is pretty powerful in that regard, where if you jump on someone, it is 195 damage if you can actually get these hits. Sad I didn't get that one as well. I was just a little bit off. I really do need to work on my rocket jumps a little bit and my gardening skills, but still really enjoying the weapon. From a very plausible standpoint too sometimes, well, let's think of it like this. It's no equalizer, but it does have its benefits. Some of the biggest downsides to weapons like the Black Box and the Liberty Launcher is that they only have the 3 rockets, and if you jump in on someone, you've only got 2 rockets to kill them. That's kind of a big downside, but the Market Gardener, you jump in, you have those 2 rockets, you switch out, smash him in the face while you're flying through the air, you kill him with that 195, and then you've still got those 2 rockets, and it kind of makes up for that and makes the Black Box and things like that slightly more plausible if you can reliably get the Market Gardener kills, which, once again, is not the easiest thing and not the most predictable thing, especially because the hit registration in TF2 is kind of wonky sometimes, especially melee hits, where you will hit people a lot of times and be like, hey, you know, where's my 195? And you don't get it. Also, got a little bit overzealous there. I was thinking that Heavy would have walked up the hill a little bit faster, and maybe I could have jumped behind him and got the medic, but overall, a huge fail there. I think I was getting a little bit too overzealous in my rocket jumping. If I'd been a little bit more patient and tried to get that medic, maybe, but sometimes still just pretty much killing myself for free. Truly, it is no equalizer. The equalizer is one of the best melee weapons in the game. Dare I say, the best melee weapon in the game. I think only competition would be things like the Extinguisher, which do insane amounts of damage quite easily. Equalizer is just so versatile. It's so nice to have that handy, but I don't really miss that because the Market Gardener is so much fun to use. It's fun to land on someone's head and instantly destroy them. And you know, on the other side of the internet, whoever you're smashing in the face with your shovel is got to be facepalming or something, because I don't think anyone enjoys being killed by the Market Gardener. Even if it's not an aerial hit and you just walk up and smash someone with it, they're probably still facepalming to a certain degree. Also, right here on the map, desperately trying to get a few rockets on that level 3 sentry that's over there. It's quite the powerful position that, if you have a Wrangler, can cover the entire horizontal area of this point. It's really dangerous to have there, so that is my number one priority, to take it down. They've even got some nice cover behind it for the engineer where he can keep repairing it and not really have to worry about getting spammed out too much. It's just pretty much the perfect spot. It's not impossible to destroy, but it is a priority. Jumping again, get this heavy, actually smash him with that, and finish this cleanup. Just kill the medic, be done with that, kill this spy. That's not going to work, John. No thank you. One thing I can definitely say, if you're going to be using this weapon, go on some jump maps, practice some rocket jumping if you're not very good at it, and definitely learn how to air strafe. Controlling your movement in the air in Team Fortress 2 isn't very straightforward, where if you press W to try and move in the direction you're trying to go, it won't really do anything. You need to strafe on the air using your A or D keys so that you can move from side to side and slowly move your mouse around so that you're changing your view and changing, you know, where your strafe will be so you can slowly move around in the air. Getting used to that is absolutely critical to being anywhere near effective with this weapon. And that is the round. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Top scoring, explosions in the sky. And I'm going to throw a couple market garden kills in here for you as well. So peace out. Like this if you did. Thanks a lot for watching.